Hello friends, myself Rahul Palkar, and today we are going to start with the module 3 of your CGV subject. Now in this module we have three different chapters. One is clipping, second one is three dimensional transformations, third one is color models. Now we will start with the first chapter, clipping. Now basically you can define clipping as a procedure where you want to display only part of a picture. Means whenever you want to display a part of a picture, no, the clipping is necessary. Now formally you can define clipping like this. It is a procedure that identifies those portions of a picture that are either inside or outside of a specified region is called as clipping. Now that specified region is going to be called as clip window. Now it is a procedure where we are going to find out the parts of the picture which are either inside the clipping window or outside the clipping window. The parts which are inside the clipping window will be kept as it is, and the parts which are outside the clipping window are going to be removed. This is basically what the clipping is. Now to understand the clipping process, we need to understand the two basic things. One is clipping window and the second one is view port. Now what is this clipping window? It specifies what do you want to see. Means it specifies what part of a picture to be displayed. And viewport, it specifies where you want to display that picture onto the screen. Okay, these are the two important things we should know to understand the concept of clipping. Clipping window, it specifies what part of a picture to be displayed, and viewport, this specifies where you want to display that part of a picture. Now the next is the window. The clipping window is specified with the help of window coordinates, and viewport is specified with the help of view coordinates. Now to understand this, what is meant by window coordinates and viewport coordinates, let us see this figure. Now the left side of this figure consists of a complete picture. Now in this complete picture you have specified a clipping window. Now you can see that rectangle inside this figure. This particular rectangle is going to be called as clipping window. Now its coordinates in the world plane are going to be the your world coordinates for that particular window. And at the right side of this figure you are going to specify where you want to display a particular part of a picture. This part is called as, going to be called as viewport. Now in your screen at this particular position the part of the image is going to be displayed. Okay, this is about the basic things of 2D clipping. Now to perform clipping, first of all you need to convert the world coordinates to the viewport coordinates. Now for that transformation is called as window to viewport transformations. Now this transformation mainly consists of three different steps. The first step is translation. Now in this step we are going to move the bottom left corner of a window to the origin. We are going to move the bottom left corner of a window to the origin. Second step is scaling. According to the needs, either you are going to scale up or down the part of the image so that it fits in the viewport. And the third step is inverse translation, which is to move the part of the image to a viewport. Wherever you want to display that viewport, no, at that part you need to move the image. Okay, these are the three steps for converting the window coordinates to the viewport coordinates. Now the next we are going to see the different algorithms which are used for this clipping process. Now these are the different algorithms which are basically used for clipping. The first one is point clipping, second one is called as line clipping, or it is also called as straight line segments. Third one is fill area clipping, fourth one is curve clipping, and the fifth one is text clipping. Now the first one, point clipping, is used for only clipping the points. Line clipping is used for clipping the line segments. Fill area clipping is used for clipping polygons. Curve clippings are used for clipping curved surfaces. And fourth, last one is text clipping, which is used to clip the text from the picture. Now we'll start with the point clipping. Now this point clipping is used to find out whether that particular clip is going to be displayed onto the screen or not. Now if we have a point P of XY, then it is going to be present in a display if the following inequalities are specified. Okay, if x is less than or equal to xv min and it is less than or equal to xv max, and y is less than or equal to yv min and y is less than or equal to yv max. Okay, where your xv min, xyv min, xv max, yv max are the edges of your clip window. Okay, if that point satisfies these two conditions, then only that point is going to be present in your output screen. If it doesn't, it is not going to be appearing in your output screen. It is going to be clipped out. Now the next algorithm is line clipping. Now this line clipping is used to clip out the lines from a clipping window. Now there are many cases we need to consider while clipping out the lines from the picture. Now basically when the line is going to be interior or when it is going to be exterior, we need to find it out first. Now whenever the two end points of a line are inside the clipping window, we can say that that particular line is interior to the clipping window. And if the two points are outside the clipping window, means that point, that line is exterior to that particular clipping window. First of all, we need to find it out first. Then after finding it out, we are going to place the lines which are there in a clipping window. Okay, if the both endpoints are inside the region, means there is no clipping is necessary, means automatically that line is going to be inside the region which you want to display. If the one endpoint is inside and one is outside of the clipping window, in that case you need to clip that line. For that you need to clip that line at the intersection point, means where it is intersecting at the clipping window. No, at that point you need to cut that line and you have to display a portion of that particular line. And the third case is both endpoints are outside the region. Now when the both endpoints of a line are outside the region, you need to see these two sub cases. The first case, whether there is intersection between those and the line and the your clipping window. If there is no intersection, it is that line is completely exterior with the clipping window, you just no need to display that particular line. If the line intersects the region, means although the two endpoints are outside the region but it is intersecting your clipping window, then you will get two different intersecting points. Now at those two intersecting points you need to cut that particular line. Now on this line clipping we have an example. Now the right side of your image consists of a picture which is before clipping. You have totally five different lines. Now amongst those five lines, the line made by P1 and P2 is completely interior to the region, because both the endpoints are interior, and the line made from P4 and P3 is completely external to this particular clipping window. The line made by P9 to P10 is also completely exterior. Now see the lines P5, P6 and P7, P8. The lines made by points P5, P6 and the line made by the points P7, P8. In P, the line P5, P6, one point is interior and one point is exterior. And the line made by P7, P8, both the points are exterior, but it is intersecting the clipping window. Now this is how the procedure is going to be applied to clip that particular image. Now this at the right side you have a same pane after clipping. Now you can see the line made by P1 is P2, it is completely present. The line made by P5 and P6 points, now at the intersection point you have cutted that particular line, and the line made by P3, P4 is completely removed. The line made by P9, P10 is also completely removed, and see that line made by P7 and P8. Now this line is being clipped at the intersection point. Now only the part of the line which is interior to the region is taken and the remaining part is removed. This is how the line clipping works.